You look lonely. I can fix that.
Have you ever thought about having a relationship like Joe from Blade Runner 2049 with an AI? Even if it sounds absurd at first, the reality of this idea is closer than you might think. Today, I will prove this to you by creating an AI girlfriend step by step using the tools already available to us. With that said, let's get started right away. First and foremost, creating our AI girlfriend is our goal. We start by defining her abilities, inspired by Blade Runner 2049. For the most realistic implementation possible, I have set specific requirements. First, I need to be able to talk to her and she to me. Second, she needs to live at my home, more precisely, on my hardware. Third, she needs an individual character, appearance, age, and so on, which I can customize and create based on my preferences. Fourth, I need to be able to exchange pictures with her and she with me. That is enough for now. We will delve deeper into this later, adding more if possible. To meet these criteria, the first thing we need is the TextGen WebUI interface. In short, this is our interface that displays the conversation between me and my AI girlfriend and offers us individual settings to create our girlfriend. The AI, that is the model that powers our girlfriend, we will download later and run it on the interface, that is, on our hardware. Some might wonder why we specifically download TextGen WebUI when there are chatbots or character.ai where we can also create our girlfriend. It is possible there too, but those are almost not as good as TextGen WebUI because many of them cost money and offer us little individual customization freedom, and many features are still missing. Moreover, I want to have a private conversation with her without it being on some server and ending up with the FBI at my door. I will now quickly explain how to install everything. If you want to learn more, watch my last video that goes into much more detail on installing TextGen WebUI. To install it, click on code, then download zip. After downloading the file, extract it with WinRAR at the location where you want the WebUI on your PC. Then open the folder where you have many files. Just remember the start.windows.bat file to run the WebUI. If you have a different operating system, there are other executable files. When you run the file, a few things that are required will first be downloaded. This will take some time. After the first download process is complete, you must decide what you want the models, the interface, to run on. You will see 5 options. Most will need to choose A because the graphics card is best for running your AI, but I choose N, that is, my CPU, because I do not want to strain my graphics card while recording. So, after I have specified N, a few more things will be downloaded and we will have to wait a bit until it is finished. When this process is completed, you will have your URL to the interface and open it in your browser. The first thing you will see is the chat view, where we will then communicate with our girlfriend, but before we get to that, let us download our AI now. The AI, also known as a large language model, we choose for our digital girlfriend is crucial for her quality. That is why I will also download the required model from the user The Bloke on Hugging Face. I went into more detail on this topic in my last video, so check it out if you want to learn more. It is just important to know that AWQ stands for use with graphics cards and GGUF for CPUs, and the description states how much memory is needed for the respective model. Pay attention to this when selecting a model. I choose the Wizard LM model here because this large language model is my favorite. There are more advanced large language models developed specifically for roleplay that enable even better communication, but Wizard LM is sufficient for my purposes. For those of you who want to dive deeper into this topic, I recommend researching on Reddit. Otherwise, if you want to keep it simple, you can find the models I recommend on my Discord as well. To download them now, simply copy the name of the large language model and paste it into the model section in the appropriate field. Since some LLMs have several variants, press Get List and see if there are any. If none are available, you can download it. Otherwise, go back and check the table for what is recommended and then add the model type below. While that's downloading, let's get an extension that gives our AI girlfriend a voice, namely from Elevenlabs. For this, we go here to snapshots from the TextGeneration WebUI. By the way, you can find all the links to the websites in the description. Then download the zip file from there. After that, open the folder, go to extensions, and drag the Elevenlabs TTS file into our extensions folder at the TextGeneration WebUI. When you've done that, open the command prompt above and enter this command here. You can find the command on my Discord. After our AI has been installed, we then go to the session section, select the extension, press apply, and restart the WebUI. While it's restarting, we go to Elevenlabs, obtain our API key, then go to chat when the WebUI has restarted and insert it below under API and press refresh. We then also select play TTS automatically so that the voice messages are played automatically and then choose a voice. This one here is a very good example of a voice. So now we have a quality voice and also a lot of choices if we want to use another one. Now we come to the creation of our girlfriend. For this, we need to go to parameters parameters and then to character. Here we can set everything about our girlfriend. I will do this briefly now and we'll be right back. So I'm done now. I have chosen the name Lara for my girlfriend, as you can see. Even if everything here looks a bit complicated, it's actually quite simple. Let me explain what I did. First, I added all her specifications to my AI girlfriend, such as age, gender, appearance, character traits, and so forth, to shape her behavior. Then I gave her a description to further develop the character. And I added a special scenario so that she can react even better to the scenario I want to play through with her. Is the scenario necessary? No, you can leave it out, just like many other things here. The AI will mostly invent something if it's not there, but I don't want to leave anything to chance, so I leave it as it is. Below, I added an example conversation so that the model can better imitate the girlfriend I created. I also chose the greeting below for how the conversation should start. And with that, I was actually finished. You don't need to describe your girlfriend as intricately as I did here. Displayed are a few examples of how it could be simply structured. The important thing is just to try what works best. For me, this format is best because it leads the conversation with me almost error-free. Ah, and almost forgotten, where you is mentioned, you can enter your name so that your girlfriend still knows how to address you if you want. It would definitely make sense to do so, but I forgot it in this case, but no matter. If you want to know more about character creation, check out Reddit at the TextGeneration WebUI. There you will find many posts on this topic. Otherwise, I have linked you to a website in the description that explains this topic further. For all my Patreon supporters, I have posted a prompt for ChatGPT on Patreon so you can create characters in my style by describing your girlfriend. You can also exchange ideas about this on my Discord and ask me questions about it. What we still need now is to create a picture of our girlfriend. I did this now on Leonardo AI with a prompt, as you can see, but you can also create the picture of your girlfriend elsewhere, on DALL-E, Midjourney, or wherever you like. After that, you can insert the picture here and adjust the size. Below, you can then insert your picture. Before we start, we still need to activate all necessary extensions. Multi-model, as you should know, is there so that we can exchange pictures with her, and Whisper TTS so I can send her audios. With SDAPI pictures, you would theoretically have the possibility that she generates pictures for you from Stable Diffusion, but unfortunately, my hardware is not sufficient for that, so I omit that. There are many other extensions that could enhance your character even more, but I omit those as well, because they would exceed the scope of this video. So, once you have completed everything, press Apply. Following that, the web UI will be restarted. We now just need to select our AI, load it, and then we can finally start communicating with my girlfriend. Now we proceed to Chat, and we can begin. As you can see, an audio has already been generated, but before we start talking to her, let's go over what you still need to adjust. You need to choose your mode from the AI. After that, select a cool chat style. You also have to choose your character. Then set Whisper TTS to medium for the model. Before we begin the conversation, I also need to first adjust the browser so that my microphone works in it. With that done, we can finally start
talking
to her.
Welcome home, honey.
To do this, I scroll down and record my audio. Hey, sweetie, how was your day?
It was okay. I got some stuff done for my new project at work. How about you?
As you can hear, my Lara has already delivered a wonderful message. It's always fascinating for me to experience the audio quality from Elevenlabs. As you can see, we can really do creative things here, but I'll elaborate more on that in a moment. Let me continue talking to my girlfriend. Had a difficult day at work.
Sorry to hear that. Want to talk about it over dinner?
Oh, it looks like dinner is waiting for me. What's for dinner tonight?
I was thinking of trying out this new vegetarian lasagna recipe I found online. It smells great, and I think you might enjoy it too. Plus, it would be healthier than our usual takeout dishes.
Okay, interesting. It always amazes me that such conversations are already possible with an AI, but I'll say more about that in a moment. Sounds good.
Great. While dinner cooks, want to tell me more about your day? I'm here for you if you need someone to talk to.
I could continue communicating with her for hours, but we don't have that time in this video. Naturally, it's cumbersome to always have to scroll down to record the audio, but I'm doing that just to demonstrate what happens. Normally, you can scroll down, have the field selected, and simply press enter to talk to her. Then you'll hear her responses through the headphones or speakers, and you can engage in small talk with her by pressing enter when you speak to her. You also have the option to send her pictures with the corresponding model. I could now send a picture of her here and say, "Hey, I took a photo of you," and she could recognize it if I had an AI with image recognition, but unfortunately, my GPU is not sufficient for that, so I can't demonstrate it to you. You also have the option to make settings in parameters here, such as how creatively she should answer and much more. If you want to know more about that, go to learn more. Everything is explained there. For all my Patreon supporters, I have provided you with a download link for my Lara so that you can write to her. This brings us to my conclusion on this topic. Even though we have not come as close to Joe's girlfriend from Blade Runner as we might have liked, the girlfriend we have have created here is very remarkable. Through her voice and intelligence, imitating a character like my girlfriend, she provides good evidence that our technology is moving in this direction. It would even be possible now to depict her at Silly Tavern with animations and facial expressions, but I will get to that in another video of mine. The point definitely is, we will probably see the first truly depicted characters in a few years. They will likely not be displayed as holograms, but one could see them through the Apple Vision Pro. How real that will seem to us and look remains to be seen, but I can very well imagine that there will be people who will really build a relationship with their artificial intelligence. That is why it is also important that we can regulate something like this, because you have to consider that the models can also be uncensored, which can naturally lead to unethical and questionable conversations. This can harm people who are easily influenced, so for you too. Use these technologies at your own risk. What do you think about this topic? Let me know in the comments.
Don't forget to subscribe and watch the last video.